You are King Kong in his story. Want the story? King Kong is a giant gorilla with supernatural strength. He was a god while he was in Africa. The reason why they call him King Kong is because Congo is Central Africa, and they're implying everybody in Africa, the Congo. The king is under the spell. In his homeland in Africa, he's worshipped by his own people. Every night, he would come to their town or their village, but yet, and he had a big fence built up against him. With me? And they would have offerings of young virgins for him. And he would come to the town, and they would put the virgins up there, and that would appease him, and he would go about his business. And they lived like that. It was all right. Everybody was happy. Some Canaanites came along, stumbled into their village, and it came evening, and they had to start running and closing the gates, if you remember. Remember that? And they got scared. They said, "What's going on?" They said, "Well, close the gates, Wabumba, Kong was coming." And they was in love with Wabumba, you know, stuff that they play. And in time, there were these large, boom, boom, steps. And they saw King Kong, and the first thing that came to their mind is how to get King Kong back to America on stage so they can make some money out of it. So what they did is they lured him with a white woman, because he was used to that. So the Africans said, if we give him her, he might not want to come back at all. See the brainwashing? So King Kong kidnaps the white woman and runs off into the woods. Thus starts the episode of the Hamorites scorned throughout Africa to get the kings, the giants, and bring them to America. Eventually, they sedate King Kong while he is trying to have a sexual relationship with this white woman. And they inject him, sedate him, tie him down, put him on a ship, and sail him through the passage over to America. When he gets to America, they present him before the public, chained down, and all these Amorites are in a party having a good time. That's you. Chained down mentally while the Amorites have a good time. He'll let you in his party, but you're going to be the clown, nigga. So moving on, it was about the music that won the case. All right, let's get back to where we was at. So what they did is they removed those instruments that vibrate with our chemistry. And now every Negro got some synthetic instrument in his basement. He's pushing little Casios and Panasonics and all fake. All removing the essence. Back to the point. The Rainbow Project, which is sending out these wavelengths that is called mind control, started back there with who? Rainbow Project. Who's Rainbow? Phoenix Rainbow. Phoenix Rainbow. Now, Phoenix Rainbow. Check who's a part of what? Phoenix. Rainbow. Velik. Remember? Time Machine, Philadelphia Experiment? Well, the Philadelphia Experiment was initially intended for the sole purpose of creating invisibility for radar, which they already have called the stuff. You understand? When they got into it, the mathematicians who got involved in it found out that also they can interfere with the brain because of what they refer to as zero time reference. That if all five or six of y'all went through a time loop here, when you came back, Abdul Bayt would be affected one way, you'd be affected another, she another, she another, and him another. They found that out. They realized that time has something to do with now. That time in the future has already happened, and time in the past is still happening. I think I told y'all about that years ago. I said, if a person's adrenaline is a high point when they die, it will stamp in now. And they will reiterate that incident. And this is why people sometimes think they're driving along and they see a ghost run across the road. and they have calibrated that they come back to that same spot every year, or sometime every 10 years, depending on how it aligns, that same thing will happen over and over again. A lot of hauntings, as they call them, they make clear that this is a haunted house. What happens? A woman walks along that staircase every night at 12 o'clock on the dock. And so people come in, they set up monitors, and lo and behold, it's a disembodied soul, an exoplasm, an etherian, an essence that is trapped in now. They can't get out of now. Now keeps happening over and over. The event was so traumatizing that they can't get out of it. It's happening all the time. It's called lost souls, trapped in limbo. They got terms for days about it. It happens already in your mind if you don't think it's possible. And I'll tell you when it has happened. There are incidents in your life where, regardless of what you're doing, you'll flash back to a certain corner where an event took place. If you had friends or something, you hung out in one spot, and it could have been 20, 30 years ago, you can flash back to that. Or you can flash back to an incident in a concert where you was having a good time. Or you can flash back to falling off a bike or whatever. But you have these things that are called now, already taking place in your mind, and you are away from it sometime 10, 15, and 20 years. Everybody here has had one of those events stamped in their mind. And that event reoccurs periodically. But what keeps you from being trapped in the now of that event is that the body is dying forwardly. You see? Because when you were born, you started dying. You hear me? And you were dying because your cells were dying. You must expire. That's why they call it expiring. Expiration. You must expire before you can become totally ethereal again. But the events that take place while you are expiring, they stamp themselves in now. Like, go back to not the Savior's Day, but the last Savior's Day, and remember an event. And when you remember the event, you are reliving right now.
Break it down.
So now is the all. The all is not moving forward with you, and the all is not left in the past with you. Everything that takes place has a purpose or it won't. Light, for instance. Light was a necessity to exist within a certain period of time in the all. Light didn't begin with the all, because if light began with the all, then the all would be light. God, Allah, Om, Theos, Hashem, Adonai, Yahweh, Elohim, all of them are events in the all appropriated for specific time zones when they needed to be. That is why I said a few years ago, before you believed in Allah, he didn't exist. Before you knew of Allah, he didn't exist. Because all that really exists to you is you right now. And when you're talking to a Negro, and they're talking about what's going to happen, you tell them that's not important. What's moving on is right now. And how much time I waste talking to you and what I benefit or lose while talking to you. Because whenever you come in contact with any two people, or any two people come in contact with each other, one is gaining and one is losing. If you give something to somebody, I don't care what they argue, they're still just another human being, you've lost. If they give something to you, you've gained. How do you utilize now? If you come out here and you talk to me, I give you something that you take with you forever. It's like saying, see that puddle over there? Don't fall in it. So now when you leave me, and as you encounter people in each event of now in your life, you come to find out things I say become important at the moment. Meaning, someone starts a conversation, and you say, that's interesting. Pop was just talking about that. Bam, you're right on. Because I need that now. You hear me? They want to alter our now. Because we have a new zero time reference. We are altering time. For all intents and purposes, it all should be over. But it has just begun. All of my beloved brothers who preceded me, all of them, the messenger, the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, the prophet, Noble Ju Ali, the seer, Marcus Garvey, all of them were leading up to now, where we can start time from here. Yes, that's it. Yes.
I was wondering if you could elaborate more on the thing you said, E1 plus E2 equals the light of the sun. Can you elaborate?
Yes. When you say E1, E2, and I know you like that subject because I watch your classes. You're pretty good. I watch you. You're a pretty good teacher. Y'all guys are doing pretty good out there.
Thank you.
When you say E1 and E2 equals the sun, light, basically all you're saying is hydrogen and helium. Right? H1 is really hydrogen. On the other side of it, there has to be an etheric light for the other sun, Utu, the etheric sun. You have the manifestation of a sun on this side, and then you have a manifestation of an etheric sun on the other side, an energy light. Let me show you what happens with that. In the Islamic world, touching on a base, you have what's called the star and crescent. You follow that? And they say that it's the symbol of the universe. It's the right symbol. It's this and it's this and it's this. It's the illusion. It's the lie. It's the confusion symbol. The reason why I say that, I'm going back to the sun. That's where I'm going there. Is because when you see a crescent, you see that? And you put a star right here, or right here from your sight. You see that in the crescent? I ask you, is that possible? Think before you answer, please. Don't want to agree with me. You know what I mean? Want to know. Is it possible for the star to sit in a crescent? Why not? That's right. Because the crescent is a moon. And the whole moon is really there. You're just seeing a portion block. And stars are further away from us than the moon. So no star could get on this side of the moon without blocking it out. It's a symbol of deception. You follow? And identifies with the triple darkness on the other side of the ether. That there is a recognition of other suns. Now, on this side of the ether, you have H1 hydrogen. Right? Again. 554 million tons of hydrogen is changed into 550 million tons of helium each second on the sun. That means hydrogen combined to make helium, 2, HE. And as helium burns, it gives off more hydrogen. Someone had to make that sun. Someone had to create that formula. Because it could never reach the helium without some outside force bringing them together to start this tumbling process. So just like that sun on this side gives light, warmth on the physical plane, on the other side, ether one and ether two produces the light of the sun on the spiritual side. And the process is ether one changes into ether two, which gives off bad information that is then rejuvenated into good information and gives off pure life. Let me tell you what I mean by that. When the man comes along that can take bad information and make it good information, he is the son of righteousness. When the man comes along that can take the teachings of the Nation of Islam, which has been corrupted information, and take that corrupted information and make it good information and healthy information for the people, that's the son of righteousness. When that man comes along that can take that Quran that has been tampered with and right the wrong in it, that's the son of righteousness. The same applies to the Torah. When a man comes along, he can take the teachings of the messenger or the prophet, Dobu Jali, and change those bad teachings into good teachings for you, that's the son of righteousness. But the man can take dead soil, and the son can come out and grow fresh vegetables in it. When I can come here and take this earth, you people, and rejuvenate life in you, and grow in you, I'm inside you like a plant, and I'm blossoming in your brain. I'm turning you into pure light without you even realizing it. When that person comes, that person is called the son of righteousness. But the sad part about it is he can only come at the end, right before the great and dreadful day. His presence represents the great and dreadful day. When the messenger of Allah, Muhammad, finished his mission, he had succeeded in turning the hearts of the fathers toward their sons. But the devil stepped in and disrupted it. And that's why I was necessary. I was off in my cradle in Ansar. I was not involved in what they were doing. But when they corrupted what he was doing for them, then it was necessary for them to take and bring the Yahweh or the Lord into existence, that I may, as the son of righteousness, turn all of this bad to good. You were falling off the cliff and you had to be caught. Meaning, you were fed up. You were being confused. You were being lied to. You were following along and you were seeing corruption in the mosques. You were seeing corruption in the synagogues. You were seeing corruption in the churches. They did not send a preacher. They did not send a religious man. I've been telling people for years, stop trying to judge me as a religious man so you can find faults in my character. I'm not a religious man. I am a teacher. Religious people don't work well with you. You need a teacher. Someone that will allow you to badger them just to give you the truth. Someone that will allow you to exercise all your egos at them just to give you the truth. You understand? So I incarnate here. So I can stand before you. And in all that you have been given, in all that you have been taught, in all that you read, in all that you think you know, when you come before me, you have to humble yourself. Because about how far the ladder you think you are, you know I can humble you. And it is better to have one man humble you and you rule all other men than to argue with me and be ruled by all other men. You follow me? It's better to stand before me as a father and let me chastise you and get you right and you look good in the eyes of everybody else than standing out there looking like a fool. Because when you see a brother on the street now in a bow tie, you follow? You be saying, he just don't know. He just don't know. When you see a follower of Yahweh ben Yahweh, you say, he just don't know. You have no idea. The biggest conversation y'all have in your travel through the day is people have no idea this is going on. Dang, look at these people. They don't even know this world is coming down. They don't even know the suppressors are here. And they don't know independence, the movie Independence is them telling them something. You know it though. And that is the blessing. Many are called. And I stood up in 1970 and I yelled and I called and I said, many are called, but few are chosen. When they get to sifting it, all of them left. Some of them are back in the street niggas. Some of them think, oh, he's so slick. He's this, he's that. No, I'm the man that's consistent in facts. Regardless of what you see me as, because you don't judge me by religious eyes and say, he's not a holy man, heard he does this, he sings music. I can do that. I can do all of that. I'm not your preacher. I ain't your imam. I told him in Brooklyn, don't call me imam. I'm not no imam. Okay, imam. I'm not a religious person. I am simply a teacher. A man coming to right the wrong. And my very presence and what I stand for and what I teach you is doing the job. A job nobody can. None of y'all can do that. And all those fools that left here, and all those that were fools that left here, all they can talk about is the teaching, not the teachings. They can talk about me and how much they don't like me and how I didn't do this and how I didn't do that, but one thing I always did was my job. Regardless of whether I neglected you, a book was still coming out for the whole of our people. You follow what I'm saying? I have many people saying, you know, brother so-and-so misses you. I said, I don't remember him. Who is he? He ceased to exist in my world because I have a job to do that's bigger than you. They don't understand a person with a mission. They don't understand your insanity about your mission. They want you to be a person. And I always tell them, if I was a person, I wouldn't be the person I am. And you probably wouldn't want to talk to me. It's the person I am that makes you want to talk to me. And in being that person, I don't have time for you unless you are in my world. Unless you want to make this happen. Unless you want to help make this happen. Other than that, I don't have enough time for you. And I'll give you enough time for you to see that I'm not fake. I'm not playing. Oh, he's just this. You don't know me. I have died for you people thousands of times. My life has been on the line for you people thousands of times. You understand? I am the only one that will get up. Nobody else got up and talked about Farrar. And all you saw it. And put my views there. Man, the Nation of Islam, I'm surprised they didn't kill him. You don't think I knew that? But guess what? My responsibility. Man, you translate your own Quran, man. Arabs will kill you. Guess what? I got a job to do. And then that's what's important to me. And the moment your life is less important to you than the job, you're going to see that everything in the universe works for you. As long as you got yourself out front, you want to party and have a good time and laugh and joke all the time, remember, you're going to be a failure. You start doing for others more than you do for yourself, and you're going to succeed. You start putting yourself in front of everything. Put other people out. Give to other people. You follow what I'm saying? And you're going to find that that power of love, that's the thing that controls me. People don't think because they don't know me. I don't express my love by sitting you on my lap and patting you. I express my love by making sure that you have a place to sit. You follow? The deal is I'm going to tell you the truth regardless of how bitter it is to others. I don't care how mad the Muslims get. Defend it. Defend it with truth, not with a weapon. Defend it with truth. If everything I'm saying about Farrar is not true, then you produce the facts. You follow what I'm saying? If what I'm saying about Islam is not true, then produce a book and prove it. I put a book out 10 years ago, 360 questions to ask a Muslim, they ain't answered it yet. All they're still trying to push is the Bilal killer book. What does it deal with? Me, the teacher. That's because they think I am like their minister, the religious guy. I'm not. I'm a person. Play Monopoly with me and I'll cheat if I can win. Just for the fun of it. And that's my way of telling you don't make me the preacher. We played baseball, I cheated. Say, he's cheating. Pops is cheating. And he was having fun. The fool was the one saying, Pops is cheating. That fool will later go off and slander. I watch the people on the internet ignore him. They can't ignore me. They're too interested in what I have to say on the internet. The room captain, whoever says, ignore him, the people are still asking me questions. Well, you see, they can't. I know that. You understand what I'm saying? I know they can't ignore me. They can't help. They're waiting tomorrow. Wait, Sunday, they're waiting for me. Our room is so full that people are mad at us. Who is this Malachi person? The only thing that's wrong is you people not coming and saying, that's God. And get them real mad to keep the conversation going. You instead of you so busy not saying, that's God right there. You know God is right there talking to you. Anything you want to know, he ain't God. Yes, he is God. He ain't God. How can a 5% say I'm not God and believe some wino in Harlem became God? Bonafide wino, ex-follower of Morris Science Temple, which is obvious by the symbol on the 5%. The symbol of the 5% is a number with a circle, a 7, and a star and a crescent with NATO symbol behind it. That 8-pointed star is NATO symbol. And the circle and the 7 is Noble Drew Ali. Don't tell me Clarence was in the Nation of Islam and never heard about Noble Drew Ali. I call you a liar. 5% symbol is a Morris Science symbol. 5% bragged that they were sitting in chock full of nuts when he said, I met the Father. And we was drinking a cup of coffee. God, Allah, in person is drinking a cup of caffeine. But I can't be God. But a wino can be God. A half white man, half white and half black could be God, who ate pork, by the way. But for all they tell you, ate pork and then told him, don't eat this. He could be God or Allah, and I can't be God. Yeah. You got some yuppie on the cross with a 1960s hippie hairstyle called Jesus. He could be God and I can't be God. Who y'all fooling, man? And only one of all those gods that show and prove their God by their works is me. And nobody touched all the scriptures. I ain't met a teacher yet. Ask your teacher, why hasn't he translated the Quran for you himself, his way to support what he teaches? Even if they say he translated the Quran to support his teaching, say then why didn't your teacher support his teaching with his Quran? And while you're talking to him, say, why, wait a minute, now let me ask the Hebrew, why didn't Ben Yahweh translate the Torah instead of putting up some old phony book that looked like his own translation, some drawing sketches, and call it their Bible from the King James Version? And then turn to the Hebrew Israelites and say, why haven't Benjamin Carter, and then turn to the Israelite church and ask, why haven't Ermi? And keep on turning around and say, how come none of your Christian preachers ever took the time to translate the scripture so we could see what it says? Why that man? Where do you get the time to do all of this? Meanwhile, writing 100 books a year, covering every subject that they ask. I write books based on what people ask you. As I listen, I say, oh, you want to know about that? I'll tell you more than you want to know. I had one person say to me, how come I didn't go to a debate with Siraj Raj? Do you know what would happen to Siraj if you mentioned a debate with Imam Isa? You make that man nervous and sick. He'll start getting sick. Ahmadinejad then died, and that was their last hope for lying and messing stuff up. They cannot deal with us. I heard a joke. Some of y'all might have heard. I thought this was funny thing I heard here. It says, not put it in our language, right? It says that there's a Nawapian, who's us, and a Christian, who's them, camping together in the woods. And a bear comes. Correct? And as they get to running from the bear takes chase. And they're running. And they're running. And the Nawapian looks over to the Christian and says, what's he going to do now? He says, I'm going to pray. You know what I'm saying? He says, well, what you going to do You know? Because that bear is catching up with us. You follow? And Wapian says, I don't have but one thing to worry about. The Christian says, what? Your religion? He said, no. Beating you in running. You understand what I mean? That's the real deal. Right, you keep praying, and I'll keep running. Your race is against the bear. My race is against you. You try to outrun him. I'm just going to outrun you, and we'll see. Shalom.